Hello, everyone. Good to see you. Welcome back to the channel. My name is KL, and today I'm watching a movie that I have not seen before, and that movie is Beverly Hills Cop from the year 1984. Now, you'll want to thank Kelvar down in the comments below. He is the one that picked this movie when he won a Member of the Month draw over on my Patreon, and the moment that I saw the title, I knew I was going to want to edit this down and bring it here for the channel. So, you're welcome. I hope you enjoy this reaction. And if you're wondering what Member of the Month is, it's one of my Patreon benefits where at the start of every month, I just take all eligible members, throw them into a random wheel spin, and the winner has a choice of either picking a movie directly for me to watch and react to, or if they're indecisive, they can pick a list of movies and it goes into a poll for the whole Patreon community to vote on. I love this benefit because it has made me watch movies that I had never heard of and probably would have never watched for my whole life, potentially. So it's been really fun to branch out. Not all movies that get picked come to the channel in edited format, but if you are interested, all the watch-alongs are available over on my Patreon, including the one for Beverly Hills Cop. And the only thing I know about this movie going in is that it stars Eddie Murphy. I'm so excited to watch another Eddie Murphy movie. I love him. I haven't seen a whole lot of his movies, but the ones that I have, I've really enjoyed. And the most recent one that I watched would have been Shrek a few months ago. I feel like I need to watch that movie every few years because it's just such a riot and such a blast. And Eddie Murphy's voice acting in that is just so fantastic. So the only prediction that I have is that because this is a cop movie and it came out in the 80s, I almost anticipate kind of like a Lethal Weapon vibe to this movie. I could be wrong, but we'll see if I'm right. And with that, thank you again so much for joining me for this movie today, and let's press play. Jerry Bruckheimer. All right, well, now I know what to expect. Ish. Nice to have you in Detroit. All right, I gotta turn the volume down.
Truck looks great. There must be a fucking fortune here.
Tell me something, fella. What's going on? Shit, check this out. I want you to see something. He's a very popular cigarette with the children. You know what this is in here?
A very popular cigarette with the children. Oh gosh.
Shit, I'm a businessman. I'm gonna sit down. Do what you want
to
do.
You're right. It ain't easy to get rid of this shit.
I know, but see, I'm a businessman, you know? There you go. That's what I'm talking about.
Shout, kid,
thank
like
you
it.
Very much. This looks like $2,000 to me. This looks like $5,000.
They stiffed us.
No, they stiffed you, because I want my money, man.
I promise I'll make it up to you.
Hey, look, man, don't jerk me off, all right, man?
Oh, police behind you.
Not $2,000 thing, man. Don't do
police.
This to me.
Look, don't be unreasonable.
Smoke them yourself in the pocket.
When are you going to notice?
I smoke king size, can't
fuck this. Nice doing business with your kid.
Oh, no.
You ain't gonna believe this shit. Check this out. The truck, it just stopped, man. It just stopped. You got some jumper cables, you give me a jump.
Both of you guys, break out some ID.
Let's get the fuck out of here!
Oh, gosh. I feel like they're gonna lose so much of their stuff. Oh, gosh. Brother, why are you hanging out at the back? You know what? Seeing him hanging on the chains like that, though, reminds me of, oh my gosh, kindergarten or grade one. Swings on the playground. I used to, like, anytime I would swing up like this, then I would hop myself off the seat and I'd hang on to the chain on my way back down. So that just made me think of that. I don't know that I understand why the cops are chasing them so badly at the moment. Oh gosh, oh no. Gosh, you better hope there's nobody just sitting in these cars. Also, the Detroit Police logo on these cars looks like something that would be on like a toy police car and not an actual police car.
Freeze, asshole!
Oh, does he know him?
Holy, we should have known it.
Oh wait, is he an undercover cop?
Hey, Axel, way to go.
Okay.
You know what he said? This is your worst fuck up ever.
$2,000 wasn't enough money if I would have took those guys and known I was a cop.
Okay. Okay. All makes sense now.
A little time for you to do.
I'm not telling you what to do, but you know what I would do?
Just lighten up. I'm not listening to you. Thank you guys.
Hey, Axel, you got a cigarette?
So Axel Foley is his name.
Is that fucking Foley in here?
All right, there's Todd. It's showtime, okay?
Hey, boss, I know what you're gonna say, but
you mind telling me where the fuck you come off going undercover without authorization from me? What the fuck is this all about?
You want to play some fucking bullshit cowboy cop? Go do it in somebody else's precinct. The mayor called the chief called the deputy chief just chewed my ass out. When the fuck did you get a truckload of cigarettes from anyway?
From the Dearborn hijacking.
That fucking bus went down last week. That truck is supposed to be in the damn pound.
Oh, boy.
You got great potential, but you don't know every fucking thing. One more time, you're out on the street. Do you understand me?
Boss, let me tell
you. Do you understand me?
Yeah, I understand.
Yeah, he doesn't want to hear anything from you right now.
Chief ain't chew it all out. You still got a little ass there.
Don't fuck with me, Axel.
He's not in a joking mood at the moment. Showing my age where when I hear this beat, I think of Crazy Frog. And not the original song. Is this his apartment or?
Hey! I see you're still breaking in people's houses. You got out 6 months ago, you just coming to see me now?
Oof.
I went out to California, get some sun.
I got 10,000 Deutsche Marks.
They're bearer bonds, they're bonds. Untraceable.
You stole them?
No.
I don't want to hear it.
Feels like the kind of guy that might just go back to old behaviors after being in jail. I don't know.
I was working.
Working where?
Beverly Hills.
Ah, what was you doing?
I was a security guard. Jenny Summers.
Jenny Summers?
She's a manager of this art gallery, the Hollis Benton Art Gallery out in Beverly Hills. I got a great idea. Let's steal a car.
Yeah, great idea.
I'm a fucking police officer. I can't steal cars no more, man.
You're a fucking idiot.
I also remember you had to go to jail behind that shit, too. Yo, how come you didn't tell on me when you got caught, man? How come you didn't tell me we're together?
It's because I love you, man.
They're both so drunk.
All right, here we go.
Axel! Hello?
What's up, Zach?
What do you got there, Mikey? Your laundry?
Jonathan Banks! Oh my gosh.
I came here to see my friend. I had him with me. There's a whole box full of those things there. I mean, I took a couple of them. I didn't think anybody was gonna miss them.
I swear, if you ever show your face out there again,
I swear, Christ, I won't. I
ever.
Won't. I won't.
Oh. All right, well.
Can I talk to you for a minute? I heard a rumor that you're gonna use Rand on this case. It's the first time he's left his desk in 12 years.
At least he's had 12 years.
You don't mind if I ask around a little bit, do you?
He's gonna be the one that wants to investigate this because it's his friend. It was his, like,
hey,
best
look,
friend.
We're talking about a friend of mine here!
Yeah.
One, a hoodlum friend. Two, a professional hit. Three, in a cop's apartment. This whole thing stinks to high heaven.
How do you know it was a professional hit?
Whoever killed your friend wasn't worried about your little narrow ass. If they were, you'd be lying beside him in that meat wagon.
True.
Well, look, I got some vacation time coming to me. I want to take my vacation now.
Going to Beverly Hills. He knows.
But if you decide to butt into this case, it'd be the longest vacation you ever heard of.
Be permanent, probably. He'll be fired. I don't know if Jonathan Banks, like, if we'll see him again in the rest of this movie. I don't remember seeing his name in the opening credits, but maybe I did and just didn't realize I had. Always good to see him in these older movies. I'm watching Better Call Saul right now, and I just watched Breaking Bad for the first time, and Mike was a great character. Oh, the 80s. Watch where you're driving, please. This kind of gives me Pretty Woman vibes, but the cop version of it, I guess, like, just going from a certain area that doesn't have a lot of wealth to an area that has an absurd amount of wealth.
Is this hotel real expensive?
Mm.
Not for Beverly Hills.
He's gonna be shocked by the price of this. Oh yeah, this place is pricey. Pricey, pricey.
Rolling Stone magazine's Axel Foley.
Sorry, sir, but there are no rooms available.
But I'm not some hotshot from out of town. I'm a small reporter from Rolling Stone magazine.
Oh boy.
I'm in town to do an exclusive interview with Michael Jackson.
It seems that we do have a last-minute cancellation. It's a suite. I'll only charge you the single room rate.
I'm sorry I got upset. It's probably from jet lag or something. What's the rate anyway?
That'll be $235 a night, sir.
Fine.
And that'll be suite 1035.
What a guy. 235 back in 84. I'm curious on that inflation conversion. I feel like nowadays you could go to just a normal hotel and pay that much for a basic room. hotels are getting so expensive. I think you're in the right place. Oh, the music in this movie makes me want to throw on an 80s playlist after I'm done watching this.
How you all doing today?
Hi.
I'm fine. My name is Serge, and how can I help you?
Yeah, I'm looking for Miss Jenny Summers.
My name is Axel Foley. And what is pertaining?
I didn't understand what you said.
Pertaining, regarding.
Oh, what's it regarding?
Only run and tell me, Summers, that Mr. Ahmed Foley is here to see...
Axel Foley. Axel.
Ahmed, Achwell.
Axel.
Foley is here to see her. He's an old acquaintance.
This guy gives me Frank Egelhofer vibes from Father of the Bride.
But you know that you want the wedding at home on January 6th, right?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Excuse me?
What are you doing here?
How you doing?
Oh, God, it's good to see you.
Curious how these guys know each other.
I want to talk to you about Mikey.
Oh, is he in trouble again?
The permanent kind.
He's dead. He came to Detroit and somebody killed him. Mikey mentioned that you helped him get a job.
The guy who owns his gallery hired him. It's a favor of me. His name is Victor Maitland.
Victor.
He's working for Victor at the gallery's warehouse. Lord Axel, I can't talk right now. I have to go upstairs.
Miss Cole, I'll call you later on.
I have a delivery for Victor Maitland.
Oh, I'll take it right upstairs to him.
But he has to get these flowers. It's imperative. I'm going to go up myself, all right?
Well, you're not ready to...
Floral delivery is my life. I have to take it up.
It's my life.
Who let you in here?
Let myself in. How you doing?
Wasn't that... Yeah, it was. Mm-hmm. Is this guy wearing a house coat? Bathrobe.
He was my best friend. Someone killed him.
Oh, my God. That's terrible.
He worked for you, didn't he?
Yes, yes, he did. How on earth did this happen? Detroit is a very violent city, isn't it?
I don't like the way this guy talks.
Exactly what was it Mikey did for you here?
I'm sorry. I didn't catch your name.
Facial expressions. Give it away.
All I want to know is what kind of...
Gentlemen, would you please show Mr. Foley to the door?
Yo, man, get the fuck off!
Wow. Literally carrying him out.
Hey, I'm fucking somebody up.
Oh, no.
You see this shit?
I got thrown out of a window, man.
Gun, partner. You have the right to remain silent.
Do you have any of your cop stuff on you?
I understand the rights.
Yeah, but tell me, son, what's the charge?
Possession of a concealed weapon and disturbing the peace.
What's the fucking charge for getting pushed out of a moving car, huh? Jaywalking?
Why isn't he telling them that he's a cop, too?
You know, this is the cleanest and nicest police car I've ever been in my life.
Also, their police logo looks more like a police logo for a vehicle.
This is nice.
This is really nice. Looks like a school.
I've never been to a cell that had a phone in it. Can I stay for a while? Because I ordered some pizza.
Oh my gosh. I love Foley. This looks very, like, high tech. I think that's what he's thinking, too, is, like, how much stuff they have.
I'm Sergeant Taggart, and this is my partner, Detective Rosewood.
That's the guy from Santa Claus.
Why didn't you identify yourself as a police officer when you were arrested?
Because I was minding my own business.
We have six witnesses that say you broke in and...
Oh my gosh, no.
What the fuck are you, cops or doormen?
We're more likely to believe an important local businessman than a foul-mouthed jerk from out of town.
Foul-mouthed? Fuck you, man.
Taggart! Come here.
Is he gonna... Well, yeah.
I apologize for striking you.
I'm Lieutenant Bogomil of the Beverly Hills Police Department. Do you wish to file charges against Sergeant Taggart?
Look, where I'm from, cops don't file charges against other cops. No, I don't want to do that.
Well, in Beverly Hills, we go strictly by the book. Now, why didn't you inform us when you came to town?
I'm on vacation.
And what business did you have in Victor Maitland's office?
I had to go to the bathroom. I was walking by. It looked like a nice, clean place.
Oh, my gosh. Also, was this guy in RoboCop? Wasn't he the bad guy?
I just got off the phone with an Inspector Todd in Detroit.
He's my boss.
He tells me you may not be very welcome back there.
Yep, these guys, I feel like you're gonna pick him up. I think they're gonna like him.
He says if you're out here investigating the Tandino murder, you needn't bother coming back. He'll have you brought up on charges and fired. What are you doing?
I'm on vacation!
Pretty good punch you got there, Taggart.
You guys are so sweet, you know that?
Thanks for bailing me out, Jen.
You know, if I'd known why you'd been arrested, I wouldn't have come.
Oof.
The day that Mikey got killed, he showed up in my apartment with a bag of German bearer bombs. I think he stole them from whoever had him killed.
I mean, if you barged into my office and I didn't know you, I'd throw you out.
Is this your car?
You just take whichever car's closest. Why were you bothering Victor? I mean, you don't think he has anything to do with Mikey getting killed?
Oh, he definitely does.
Cops, they're following us. Beige Ford.
Yeah, he def called that. I didn't.
How can you afford this?
They always charge me the single room rate.
How can you afford that?
Yes, this is Mr. Axel Foley in Suite 1035. Yeah, I'd like to order something from your late supper menu. But listen, I want you to deliver it to this beige Ford that's parked out on
Beach. Oh, my gosh.
Bend down.
Great, a sport. How long are you going to stay?
I'm going to be in town to find out who killed Mikey. And I'm very seriously considering going down to that warehouse where he worked.
And how are you planning on getting in?
You? I love this.
Compliments of Axel Foley.
Foley? How do you know we were here? Because I let you drive.
Just give them to him. Yeah. Oh my gosh.
There's the Mercedes. We get rid of that stuff?
Oh no. I really hope that she's not involved in some way. I don't get that feeling, but.
You find something?
Coffee grounds. You know what this stuff is used for?
Yeah, some people filter hot water through it and drink it.
Yeah, I'm gonna take this home and filter hot water through it and drink it in the morning.
Oh gosh, hurry.
I tell you, I wish you would have been with me last night. Some guy comes in, he sits down a couple of stools away. Thought I'd take you over there tonight.
Okay.
Come on, let's go. I wanna get out of here.
Get off my back.
Have you ever driven a Mercedes before?
No, but a car is a car. I drive my car every day.
I'm driving. I've seen your car.
Banana in your tailpipe. How could you not notice a man sticking a banana in your...
Send us a late supper, sir. See, this waiter comes over. Really?
And what did you have, Rosewood?
I think it was a shrimp.
Oh, my gosh.
I want you two to go back to the hotel and wait for Foley to show up.
We've got something for you, Billy. An answer.
Oh, no.
Disguise.
Come on, Billy. Let's go.
He's so over it.
Why don't you take the car and go on home? I want to find out what this place is.
Oh, I can tell you that. It's a bonded warehouse. They hold our foreign shipments here till they clear customs.
Just take the car and go home, okay?
Damn it, Axel.
He just doesn't want her getting in trouble. And he can find his own way back. Oh no.
How you doing?
What is he gonna say?
Can you come here for a second, please? Is your supervisor here? Can you go get him for me, please? Are you security here?
Yeah.
Then you're the fucking problem. Go get your supervisor, please.
All right, we'll see how smooth that goes.
He didn't come back yet.
Well, what do we do now?
You sit and wait. I feel like a lot of police work is that, just waiting.
I'm Inspector Rafferty, United States Customs Service. Has all this stuff passed through customs already?
No, this is the bonded area.
How can a black man, dressed like me, just march into your warehouse, walk into the bonded area, and start poking around without anyone asking me any questions?
Oh my gosh.
Well, I don't know.
Well, thank you. That's the answer I was looking for. This place has the worst security in the nation. We're gonna check the background of each and every crate, starting with this one right here.
By the time the average American is 50, he's got 5 pounds of undigested red meat in his bowels.
What?
Why are you telling me this?
I'm just passing the time.
You got some kind of warrant for this?
Are you hiding something from me? Is that what you're doing? I can have 25 agents down here in 15 minutes, snatch your bond from underneath you, and you guys will be out of business. Is that understood?
Don't get upset, Inspector. We'll give you everything you need.
I don't know what y'all think I am. Take me for some kind of fool. Hurry up, quicker.
Eddie Murphy is so good. The man does not stutter once.
Jesus. Look, man, if you're still mad about the banana thing, I'm sorry, all right?
Yeah, very funny. Lieutenant Doctor's 2 days pay.
Get out of here. He's not kidding.
No, he's not kidding.
No, he's not.
Look, all three of us are cops. We should be working together. We all had a very rough day today.
Three heads are better than one.
Why don't you say, you know, we just go get something to drink together? Let's be friends.
We don't drink on duty.
So on the way over here today, it's perfect for you guys.
I was pretty confident he meant strip club. Oh boy.
Billy. Coffee ground.
Yeah.
So?
Is he gonna... Oh? Were those two the guys that hauled him out? Or does he know this guy from something else? I can't remember the faces of the guys that carried him out of that place.
That guy over there in the black coat? Well, it's June. Don't you think it's kind of hot for a long black leather coat?
Diggle was partying over there and it just came in together. Something's getting ready to go down.
Oh, okay.
That guy for me, all right? Go check out this asshole at the bar.
I love that he's still sitting here like...
Hey, man, what's happening? I'm not you.
Oh, my gosh.
Everybody freeze! Telling you to get back. If you don't get back, I'm gonna blow your fucking brains out.
Please, move and I'll kill you.
Don't move!
Oh, Billy.
You're some kind of cop, you know that?
Sorry for the disturbance, folks. Everything's under control.
Yeah! Oh, it feels good for them to have done something. I didn't realize that was just like a random thing. I thought those two guys were guys from earlier that I just didn't recognize, but anyway.
The only reason that they were at a strip bar is because they were tailing me and I went to this place. These guys waited outside, and the only reason that they came in was because they saw two suspicious-looking gentlemen with bulges in their jackets going into the place. Turns out that these guys were gonna commit a robbery, sir.
I like what Foley's doing here.
I did not know what was going on. I was watching the show having fun. I don't know what you teach these fellows. They're not just regular cops.
Tiger.
Is this what really happened?
Just say yes. Please say yes. Oh, no.
Foley observed the two suspects casing the establishment. Before we knew what was going on, he'd already disarmed one of them. Detective Foley deserves all the credit.
Aww. For this. Okay, Tiger and Billy are good guys.
Mm-hmm. In the future, if you want to practice law enforcement, I would prefer you did it in Detroit.
Aww. Nah, he's gonna end up getting hired here.
The super cop story was working.
It was. If they'd he knows too. He would have believed it. I mean, these guys are honest. That's important. But Foley was trying to do a good thing.
Foster, McCabe, your turn. Don't lose him.
Not a chance, sir.
In my office.
Oh, no. I hope they're treated okay. What is this now? For the new guys?
Coffee and donuts.
And milk. Yeah, they did not get suckered into the coffee and donuts. Billy would have been all over that.
Morning, officers. What y'all, the second team?
We're not going to fall for a banana in the tailpipe.
You're not gonna fall for the banana in the tailpipe?
Oh my gosh.
Look, man, I ain't falling for no banana in my tailpipe.
See, that's more natural for us. You've been hanging out with this dude too long.
In this Victor Maitland's house?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, I seen enough. Y'all want something to drink? Beer or something? I got some stuff in the trunk.
These guys aren't gonna fall for things like the other two did.
Takeout? No. I'm picnicking. This is like a picnic area.
The gate's opening.
Well, guys, excuse me.
I love that this song is like the main theme for this movie. Oh, dude. I think you meant to do that then. Aero Club, fancy place.
I'm looking for Victor Maitland. Tell him that Ramon went to the clinic today and I found out that I have herpes simplex 10. Victor should go check himself out with his physician to make sure everything is fine before things start falling off on the man.
Perhaps you better tell him that.
I'm back.
Oh, what's he gonna do?
Why don't you get the hell out of here, cuz?
Get the fuck away from me, man.
What do you want?
Last time we met, I didn't get a chance to talk to you. I know that you're into a lot of crooked shit. And I have a pretty good idea that you had Mikey killed. And when I find out for sure, I'm gonna fuck you up real bad.
I don't know from under what stone you crawl, or where you get these ridiculous ideas about me. You haven't the slightest fucking idea who you're dealing with.
I don't think he realizes who he's dealing with, yeah.
Gotta go now, Vic. Catch you later, Vic.
I can't wait.
Why are you bothering Victor Maitland?
I had a friend named Michael Tandino that used to work for Victor Maitland. Maitland had him killed. I can't prove that right now, but when I do, you'll be the first to know.
Talk to me.
Nice. Let's have a conversation.
I did some poking around, and art's not the only thing that he deals. Saw some guys unloading a crate that was filled with German bearer bonds. Tandino had bonds like this on him.
Doesn't necessarily mean he's a killer.
He's a smuggler. okay? Maitland is paying someone so his guys can get the shipments out of customs before they get inspected. They take the drugs or the bonds out of the crates, and they send it back before customs even knows what's going on.
And you witnessed all this?
Everything except for the drugs. But I found coffee grounds all over the warehouse.
They're sometimes packed in coffee grounds. If you'd found the drugs, that's one thing. We don't have enough to get a search warrant.
Guys, I know how we can get around
this. We don't get around search warrants in Beverly Hills.
They're by the book.
Sir. Forces.
Hello?
Lieutenant, I'd like to see you in your office.
Oh, no. I really like the lieutenant. I hope he's not in trouble.
Just a man who wrecked the buffet at the Harrow Club this morning.
Lower your voice, for Christ's sake.
Oh, I don't have a good feeling.
Take Detective Foley back to his hotel room and escort him to the city limits. When you get there, you can give him his gun back. The two charges of disturbing the peace have been dropped against you. But the chief says if you return to the city of Beverly Hills, the charges will be reinstated and you will be prosecuted to the limit of the law.
Well, he seems to have enough to follow.
You want to tell that to the chief?
No, sir.
Then I suggest you get moving.
I don't think he's going to be able to let it go. Like, obviously, you know, Axel won't let it go, but the lieutenant, I think, is on his side with all this and wants to investigate.
Grew up in the same neighborhood.
Oh, really? Have you seen him lately?
He came in yesterday.
Oh, he came by here?
He told me that Mikey had been killed.
Yes, I know.
I haven't seen him since.
I have some information which just might be helpful for him.
No, I have no idea.
We'll have dinner soon, yes?
Well, that'd be lovely.
Take care.
Guy gives me the creeps. It's the way he talks and the way he looks at people.
This is a chance for me and you to blow this case wide open to two of us. What do you say?
I wish I could, because Bogomil would kill me.
Billy.
How can you be sure if it'll be drugs or something?
I got a hunch, okay?
A hunch.
You know, I'm starting to think that everybody in this goddamn town is a robot.
I love you. I just fell in love with you.
I like Billy, too.
Yeah, well, look, the reason I came down here is because I want to get back inside the warehouse.
How about I go with you? I want to go check it out for myself.
Right, don't make a move until I come out and get you. I don't see why I can't come in.
You can't go in because you're a cop in this town.
But nothing. Just be cool, all right? If anything jumps off, I'll come in and I'll get you, all right?
More sitting and waiting, Billy.
Well, it looks like they've been here already. And it's coffee on top. This ain't sugar.
Welcome to the party.
They were waiting. All right, Billy, it's time to... you gotta shoot something.
Seems we have guests.
Oh my god, that is a huge fly. Where did it come from? It scared the shit out of me. So sorry. I don't think the fly can fly anymore. Oh, that's not a fly. That is a different bug.
I just can't tell you how disappointed I am to find you here.
Victor, listen
up. Shut up! I don't want to hear it.
What are you going to do with him?
You should be more worried about what we're going to do with you.
Yeah, Jenny, don't worry about me. We got cocaine and coffee here. We're going to get wired and have a big party. Thanks for having me over.
Okay, you got to do something now. Come on. Come on. You have to do something. Yep. Come on.
If something happens to her, I'll kill you.
That would be a neat trick.
Well, cuz.
Are you still pissed at me?
Oh, no. But I should have taken care of you in Detroit. When I popped your little buddy.
Goodbye, Mr. Foley.
They're such cowards, they can't even kill him themselves. Okay, you gotta do something, dude. You gotta go run into the warehouse. You'll have all the evidence you need right there. Billy, come on. Come on. The one guy had a gun. Why? Is it because of the noise, or do they just want to beat him up?
Freeze!
Ooh. Got him. Got him. All right, time to go rescue the damsel in distress.
Tell Patrick to check out the warehouse at that address and act on whatever he finds. I'll explain it to him later.
What the hell is going on?
Just check out the warehouse and please don't say anything to Bogomil.
Right now his car is heading north on Palm Canyon Road.
Foley was up there looking over Maitland's house.
Do you have the address of that warehouse? You two check that place out and find me and let me know what the hell is going on over there. And don't talk to anybody but me.
Okay, good. Good, good, good.
Everything he said about Maitland is right. Now he's kidnapped a woman and he's got her in this house.
Well, let's go in there and get her.
The fuck do you think I'm trying to do here?
Stop working on that lock. You're coming with us.
I'm gonna open up this door and I'm going inside. You want to stop me? Shoot me.
Well, they're not gonna do that, so.
Me too.
Billy.
Oh, Billy.
You know what you want, but I'm going in with Axel.
Aw.
If you're lucky, you'll just get fired.
I think he's okay with that. This is the most exciting shit that Billy's done this whole time, this whole career so far.
I'm sorry, Sarge. I've got to.
Aw. I'm really curious how young the actor is in this movie, because he looks so young. Yes.
Who the hell is that? Better get Maitland up here.
Oh, Bogomil. Yep, he's alive.
Get some people out there right away.
Oh, no. Just go a different way. You're gonna be out there for half an hour.
609 Palm Canyon Road. A Victor Maitland, sir.
Time for him to get in his own car and come and help. You guys, at this point, just go a different way. Oh gosh.
Drop it!
You just killed a man, dude.
Good shot, Billy.
Let's go.
That was a good shot.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, these guys are serious.
I hate machine guns.
Same. Careful.
Put it down as a 998. Officers need assistance. Undercover's on scene.
Sir?
Just do it.
Good shout. How many dudes are out here?
Police! You're all under arrest!
There, yeah. It's not gonna work. Nice try, Billy.
You do that again, I'll shoot you myself.
Careful. Yep, careful, please. Think to look behind you, because this man will not hesitate to kill you. Ooh, yep. Did he get him? Oh, careful. You don't know this house.
You know what I keep thinking about? You know the end of Butch Cassidy? Redford and Newman are almost out of ammunition. The whole Bolivian army is out in front of this little hut.
I haven't seen this movie that he's talking about.
I'm going to make you pay for this.
No. You're going to love him when all is said and done. You're going to be proud of him. There we go. No! Oh, you son of a bitch. Ouch.
You gonna hang around here?
Fuck no.
Hopefully they block their way out, if that's possible. Wow, there's a lot of cops. Didn't think that this many people would come.
Axel!
Be careful, old boy. They might hit me.
Freeze!
How did he go from being shot up against a wall to then rolling down the stairs?
And take two steps back with your hands!
You go, Billy. Hell yes.
very good
indeed.
Great.
I feel like this whole crew is finally getting a taste of like cop action, the kind that happens all the time in Detroit.
What the hell's going on here?
Well,
oh shit.
What's this man doing here?
Bleeding, sir.
Rosewood.
He isn't actually in custody, sir.
Wouldn't you like to hear my report first, sir?
Yes, come on.
Miss Jeanette Summers, the manager of Mr. Maitland's art gallery, discovered large quantities of a substance she suspected was cocaine in the art gallery's warehouse. Detective Foley was cooperating in a joint Beverly Hills, Detroit investigation of narcotics trafficking. Discover approximately 80 kilos of cocaine, and I dispatched our officers to this location. Sergeant Taggart joined Rosewood, with Detective Foley present only as an observer, and proceeded to enter the grounds. We shot several suspects, including Mr. Maitland.
Hell yes.
You expect me to believe that report?
Yes.
That's the report I'm filing, sir.
Why don't you tell me what happened?
Start speaking, it looks suspicious.
Happened just like the lieutenant said, Chief.
I suppose congratulations are in order.
Mm-hmm.
A report better be on my desk in the morning.
You were lying your ass off.
Don't say that too loud.
Excuse me, sir.
I was hoping that you could, like, call in my Inspector Todd, straighten things out for me, but that's all right. I guess I'm just out of a job. It's cool, though.
No, you're not. He's gonna hire him.
Were you really?
Yes, you bet.
I mean, either way, it's fine. Kind of want him to stay here, though.
Hey, guys, y'all didn't have to come down to see
send-off party.
Excuse me, the Beverly Hills Police Department is picking that up.
Nice.
You saved my life, okay? Token of my appreciation. I want you to have this fine Beverly Palm Road. I want you to think about Axel Foley. I love you, Billy.
Thanks, Axel.
This is for you.
You keep it as a souvenir.
I already have three of them in my bag.
Oh, my God.
Why, aren't you guys gonna tell me to the city limits anyway?
Yes, we are.
I was thinking about stopping off and getting something to drink, though.
Yeah, we sort of figured you would.
That mean you guys gonna join me?
I don't think so, Axel. We're still on duty.
Well, I don't think one beer's gonna kill us, Billy.
Oh, he's coming around. It's not just gonna be one drink, though, is it?
Where are we going anyway?
Just follow my lead. You guys will love it.
Do we get to see where they go? Or is the movie's just gonna end? Cool. He was Dick Jones in RoboCop. I much prefer him in like a nice cop role or like a nice character role for sure. If you enjoyed my reaction to Beverly Hills Cop, the best and fastest way to let me know is clicking that like button down below. And if you're willing to leave a comment, you should let me know if I should check out the other movies in this series. Oh my gosh, that movie was so much fun. Such a riot. I love when movies like this are around the hour 40, hour 45 minute mark. I just find that honestly the perfect length for a movie like this. You're able to fit in all of the story, the humor, the action, the banger soundtrack when you have one like this movie. By the way, I totally forgot that Crazy Frog, the name of the actual remix of this song in this movie is called Axel F. I totally forgotten about that. I always just called it the Crazy Frog song because I know they've made other songs, but none that popped off the way that Axel F did. Anyway, that song was stuck in my head for like a full 2 days after watching that movie. Gosh darn, what a great song. The story in this movie was relatively basic and easy to follow, which I love because it allows you to kind of focus more on just the humor and the dialogue and what is said. And Eddie Murphy, highlight for me from start to end, this man, the way that he can speak, deliver this humor, and just how fast he talks is really enjoyable for me. I am someone that watches nearly every YouTube video at like 1.5 times speed at least, because I just find the majority of people talk too slowly, and I've gotten better at not talking so fast when I speak, but back in the day I used to talk absurdly fast because it's just the way that my brain prefers, I guess. So yeah, Eddie Murphy talking in this movie was just pleasurable for me. All of the Beverly Hills Cops were super fun, and I love that Eddie's character like showed them the ropes, you know, kind of like brought his Detroit-isms over and just kind of acknowledged like, you guys are doing things a little bit too much by the book. And listen, I think that cops especially should do things by the book, but there are certain circumstances, I think, where it is reasonable to expect a little bit of leeway and leniency, and that was certainly brought over, and in the end it worked out for good reason. So the bad guys in this movie were ridiculous but fun, and the thing is, Jonathan Banks now, like, because of Breaking Bad, and I'm currently making my way through Better Call Saul, if you're interested, those are all on my Patreon. Just anytime I see Jonathan Banks in anything else now, I just immediately like the character, no matter what they do or who they are, just because it is Mike Ehrmantraut as him, you know? So if you can't tell, Mike is like one of my favorite characters in the Breaking Bad, Better Call Saul world. I really liked the lieutenant probably more than I would have if I hadn't just recently watched RoboCop. And if you haven't seen that reaction, I definitely recommend checking it out. I loved that movie so much. Still thinking about it all this time later, but seeing that actor in a role like this compared to Dick Jones from RoboCop, like, I just really, really prefer him as like a nice guy. I thought that he was great. Loved the lieutenant. Just felt empathy towards him, but also like frustration in a way of being like too by the book, right? So having that character arc happen the way it did, where he went from being a little bit tight about things to kind of loosening up a bit and acknowledging that, you know, sometimes you do have to rule bend a little bit, was just really cool to see. I definitely had a little bit of an expectation going in that this would be kind of similar to Lethal Weapon, and like, I do see the similarities, but they're also very, very different movies. Lethal Weapon had a lot more action in it than this movie did, but I definitely enjoyed the more humorous angle with this movie. Had a great time. I do expect the other ones to kind of be the same. I expect similar characters to reappear. I would be interested in watching the rest because I had fun with this one, so I kind of just want to continue that. And even if the general consensus is that the other ones aren't as good, I don't care. I still want to see them. I think the last thing I have to say from my own head is that Axel Foley as a name is pretty fucking badass. Like, even just Axel by itself, what a great name. Does anyone else think that Axel is a super sweet name? Is anyone watching named Axel? Anyway, I'm ready to go to Letterboxd now and check out what some other people have to say. Let's go. First up, a 3-star review by Sam, who says it would be easy to credit Murphy for making this idiotic caper work because he's amazing. But director Martin Brest is the real MVP here, making sure every scene, every character, every relationship is specific and real and funny. This is directing. I've also long wondered if it would be possible to pull off a human character who behaves with the same fearless comic bravado as Bugs Bunny. Turns out it is possible because Eddie Murphy did it. Oh my god, that's horrible. I'm only gonna share the first sentence of this review because it's a longer one, but 4 stars by Ben, who says, even back during the 80s, Mike from Breaking Bad looked like he was 102 years old. That is so not fair, but oh my god, that just made me laugh. Oh, Jonathan, you did not look 102. And finally, a 3.5-star review by Marmar, who says, Eddie Murphy has the best laugh in Hollywood history and nobody has come close to touching it. If you disagree, let me know in the comments who has a better laugh. All right, and with that, it is time to turn it to you, and I ask you to leave your comments down below. Emoji assignment, police car, of course, we have to. It's a cop movie. I'm looking forward to hearing your thoughts on this movie. Do you love it? Let me know why. Do you kind of feel like it's mid? Let me know why. Do you not like this movie? Also, let me know why. Looking forward to reading them and replying to some of you. Wish I could reply to everyone. I just don't have the time. But thank you so much for watching. Thank you for engaging on this video. To everyone over on Patreon, thank you so much for your financial support to help keep the channel going. And with that, if you're not yet subscribed to the channel, we're getting closer to 25,000 subs, which is crazy. Click on over here. And if you want to continue watching something else, click on over here. And with that, we will see you in the next reaction. Take care, everyone.